Hi, Mortgage Heroes. Andy Cruz here in Business Development, and this is Monday Mortgage Minute. Welcome back to a new week. We have a lot to talk about this week, but first, if you missed last week's video newsletter, click on the link in the top right hand of this screen and watch that video. I go into a deep dive detail of why it is we've arrived where we're at and why we are going to make the suggestions we're making coming into the last quarter of the year. All right, let's jump into this week's topic. And the first thing I'm gonna talk about is home equity. Home equity is at all-time highs. The last time we saw a surge of home prices going up this fast, this quickly, was actually the last housing surge in the early 2000s. Now, don't be concerned. That does not mean there's an imminent collapse around the corner, but we are going to see a change in home prices coming up soon, but that has to do with monetary policy. That's the next thing we're gonna talk about today. When the Fed came out and made their comments recently and they talked about how they're gonna start tapering, they're gonna remove their participation from the market, which means the market's gonna absorb more risk on their own. They're gonna price that in and rates already started to tick up a little bit. Now, since that initial move upwards, they have slowed down a little and we're not expecting that it's gonna be a crazy week when it comes to mortgage rates, but you do need to be aware that the window for refinancing at the low lows is closing. The lowest rates we saw in 2020 and 2021 are not the rates that we're seeing today. And that doesn't mean that we can't maybe dip in there on a good day and scoop them up, but that's gonna be a really, really, really sliver type window to get in there and take that lock. So what you ought to be thinking of right now are, what are my opportunities to get my mortgage refinanced, whether it's a rate and term, cash out, pay off some debt, get your VA loan out of VA and into conventional so you can use your VA when you move out of state or when you PCS somewhere else. More of the situational type refinance if you just happen to miss the low lows of months past. So the window of that is closing. We're gonna make a big surge here in quarter four trying to help as many people as possible because the Fed announced that they're going to be done tapering by mid-2022. So although we don't know exactly when it's going to begin, we do know when it's gonna end, and that is mid next year. Now, the other thing to keep note about and to kind of keep your eyeball on is that you're gonna see some buyer behavior change. And you might have already seen some of this if you're in the market or you have friends that are in the market. Buyers are being way more selective right now. You kind of see the tale of two cities, right? You have buyers who are in the market and they're like, I'm going to get a house no matter what, and they're just chomping at the bit. And even though the rate might have changed, they're still out there making offers and they're actually getting less competition because there's not as many people bidding and overbidding as there once was. Now, the other side, you see people who are ready to buy and they're still ready to buy now, but they're not going to look at the pending inventory or the current inventory. They're gonna look for strictly new builds. They're like, look, the cost of the price of the home is high, the cost of the money is costing more, I want that place to be a brand new place. So we see kind of a little bit of a divergence happening where there are some people that are gonna do whatever they can just to get in the market, and there's other people that are gonna hold out a little bit and just take the new home and the new home only, otherwise, man, all bets are off. So I think that's an indication of some behavior that's changing. Plus, what you're gonna start to see is when prices slow down, they're increasing still, but they're gonna eventually slow down and probably flatten out. That's going to mean that you're gonna have less people bidding probably, and that means that you're gonna have longer listing times. So if you're thinking of selling your home, you need to act quickly right now to get your house prepared to look perfect when it hits the market so you can get top dollar while people can not only still want to pay it, but honestly still can pay it. Now, lastly is just a heads up from a historical perspective. October can be a wild month in the markets. The financial markets tend to have pretty wild Octobers, and the mortgage market really isn't, you know, aside from that. It's included in that because of how mortgage-backed securities trade. So just be aware that if you're making decisions in this month, it is really imperative and important that you are in close communication and contact with the loan officer, ask all the questions you need to get answered, and make a strategic decision that helps you in the long term achieve whatever your mortgage and real estate goals are. Okay, thank you so much for watching this week. I know that was a lot. Please remember to go and watch last week's video newsletter where I talked all about why we got where we're at as far as rates and what kind of opportunities still exist for you. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you again next week.